What I want to do is I want to get into the attacks that come my way. They're not really attacks, but people say, the stuff you're saying on the show is not really happening. Like, there's no teachers out there really grooming kids.
Oh, my God.
And again, I want to say I'm on the side of teachers overall, but the educational profession is getting slammed by a system that's not in your court. They're not in your favor. So I'm fighting for you here. I'm trying to expose today's spot that is tomorrow's rot, if you will.
But they are indoctrinated. They don't even know it, though. Like, this has been happening.
They don't. Well, many of them don't.
The 1960s.
Yeah.
Like, it's in the Communist Manifesto. It says it, that to destroy capitalism, you have to destroy the family. And they say specifically through gender and through race. That's what it says in there. And the way to do that is to undermine the school systems, because they don't reproduce like we do. So that's the thing.
Have you ever read the book or looked through the book, The Babylon Bee's Guide to Wokeism?
No, I didn't.
It's fantastic. I bought like a dozen copies. I've still got six more. I need to bring you one or send you one. It's fantastic. I was looking through that yesterday because I'm writing a song. CJ and I are writing a song called We Can't Date. And it's about, you know, you have all these woke ideologies. Your mother may think you're great, but we can't date. And so it's kind of a funny song. So I was looking for verbiage in that book, and they got a whole chapter on how the education system, they take it from a satirical view, but how the educational system is designed to separate the child from the parent.
It is.
And so these teachers, and I know you're smart. Listen, my oldest daughter, she's an educator. She's a teacher. I get it. You're smart people. But the system's built for you to not succeed. It really is. So here's one. Filipovich. I never can say her name. Jill Filipovich. I don't say her name a lot, so I can't say that I never. She did some tweeting. April 12th. She said more mothers. Well, first of all, she said stay at home mothers are psychologically and emotionally worse off than working mothers by just about every measure, from depression to anxiety to anger. They're much more likely than working mothers to say that they are struggling, and less likely to say that they are thriving.
Where's she getting this information?
I don't believe that at all.
I don't believe that at all.
And listen, I'm going to do a whole study here soon on another episode and just talk about how men and women, I keep talking about how we need real men, we need real women.
100% real men and real women, because women aren't real women either. Nope. Like, women are destroying themselves.
And I are on the same page there.
Facts.
We're anti, militant feminist. You know, the militant feminism movement is not true femininity. It's not. I believe that we've gotten things out of order. I believe that women who have the ability to stay at home, to raise their children,
should,
to be loved, protected, provided for, are sheltered in a way. And yeah, you say, whatever, call me what you want to say. I'm done. Yeah, listen, we've already seen your system. Your system's shit, okay? We've already seen it. It sucks. It's in the cesspool of history. We've already seen it. So maybe we go back to some of these historical values that are out there that say, you know what? Women do better in an environment where there is a man to take care of them. There is a home that they can take care of.
There's no such thing as a woman, right?
So
there is no such thing as a woman. So how are they even defining that, right? So if they're doing studies on women, like, really? Yeah. Who?
I've never met a real woman that didn't want to feel secure.
That's the first thing that they want.
I never met a woman that didn't want to be protected.
It's actually biological, right? Like,
yes.
Women, because we have a limited number of eggs, right? We value resources.
Yeah.
Where men
come on with it. That's right.
Go out and do whatever they want. Like, yeah, that's kind of what happens.
You know, Andrew Schwartz has a comedy bit out there. It's hilarious. He's like, boy, women really played the long game on this equality thing. He was like, because when we were out there fighting bears and lions and getting cut in half by the gladiators, they were out there going, yeah, y'all go do your thing. We're going to stay at home. But as soon as they got air conditioning in the office buildings, they were like, equality.
so true, though. There's something to be said, though. Like, why don't you want to stay home with your children? Like, where is that genetic nurturing component to your life? That should be your ultimate priority.
That's
your children.
Right. It's a mess. I don't know. I'm so frustrated with so many of these different things. People, and you come at me. I'm gonna do a whole thing. I'm gonna expose the whole deal.
I like this, Chad. Keep going.
Because Jill Filipovich, she said more mothers at home makes for worse, more sexist men who see women as mommies and helpmeets. Men with stay-at-home wives are more sexist than men with working wives. They don't assess women's workplace contributions fairly, and they're less likely to hire and promote women. She said, also, just give people a little extra money when they have babies and don't consign people to living in poverty. Several European countries have child payments, and that makes sense.
You know, I'm actually weird about maternity leave. I don't think that it's fair.